staying with the economy, Professor, the BSP has been very aggressive in cutting the interest rates. You think we're doing enough, and are there any unintended consequences do you feel?
Well, monetary intervention is just one of them. I think there are many other things that we can do to stimulate the economy. Right now, the demand is still very weak. Why? Because people do not have money. So even if you lower interest rates, if people cannot buy because they do not have money, because there's so much unemployment, the economy will still have a hard time picking up. So in addition to monetary, I think the interventions from BSP is good. However, you have to put money in the pockets of our people so that they can buy. Right now, they're not buying simply because they don't have money.
Yeah, but on the other side of that, not on the side of the demand and not on the side of the consumers, but on the side of the businesses and the industries and enterprises that we're trying to encourage to move, are we seeing an effect of those rate cuts in terms of people starting to ramp up their investments?
Well, I noticed that people are just refinancing their old costly debt. And I think, of course, it makes sense. If the interest rates are low now, why keep your old expensive debt? Are people also financing invest? Are they investing in capital projects? I think they're still holding back. Most of the financing that we are seeing right now, because of monetary interventions, are mostly for refinancing.
I said, let's put that in layman's terms. Ibig sabihin nyo, bumaba ang interest rate, so yung mga negosyante, may opportunity sana sila, gusto ng BSP. Sige, invest pa tayo para gumalaw yung ekonomiya natin. But they're just, basically, they're just getting new loans para pagta yung higher interest rates nila. And that is not necessarily going to generate new economic activity or just slower?
Well, actually, pagka nag-refinance tayo, pinalitan natin yung lumang utang ng bagong utang, walang production doon. Basically, nagtipid lang tayo sa interest rate.
Does it save jobs at least? Does it at least keep a company afloat and your jobs safe? Humaba ba ng konti man lang yung PC mo?
Ah, yes, oo, definitely. Definitely, yung pondo nila, medyo tumagal-tagal, kasi imbes na ipagbabayad lang ng interest, ngayon, pwede nilang ipasweldo, o kaya pwede nilang dagdagan yung kanilang inventory. Pero right now, purely monetary is not going to make it. I really think that we need to look at ano bang mga produkto, ano bang serbisyo ang merong interest ngayon, ang may demand ngayon. And I think it's very clear. Everybody rushed to digitizing. Everybody rushed to transforming their operations. All of a sudden, now online transaction is very much around. Na accelerate natin. Whereas before, we still love to go to the bank, mag-transact, call our bankers, call our representatives, and still make physical transactions. Pero right now, marami ang transactions are happening online. So, what does that mean? It's not only happening here in the Philippines, it's happening worldwide. So, I was hoping na makita ito na ang ating opportunity pala ngayon ay mag-provide ng technical expertise para ma-transform ang ating mga processing into an internet-based transaction. So, ang IT natin, I thought, would pick up. Instead of just losing our mga BPOs natin, dapat nadudun na tayo sa mga IT applications development, software development. Ang Zoom, by the way, they were not expecting that this will create such a windfall for them. But now, ang demand para sa services nila more than double. So what does that mean? Everybody requires digital technology. So, dapat doon tayo nag-share. Dapat doon na tayo pumaporma. Dapat doon na tayo pumofocus. Kasi ang demand for digital transactions ay global, no? Worldwide. So, the money that we were losing with our OFWs coming home, with BPOs slowing down, with games, no, almost stopping, dapat dito tayo nakashift. No? Nag-digital tayo. No? Yung mga programmer natin, magagaling ang mga Filipino programmers. And right now, very low ang entry level, no? ang barrier to entry in this kind of business. So, sana ito ang maging focus ng mga negosyante natin. Immobilize natin ang ating mga technology experts, ang ating mga programmers. Let's look at what the global market for internet-based transactions require, and that's provided that.